luminous body. Luminous means the body which emits, the body which emits light by themselves. By themselves. What I'm saying, the body which emits, which emits light, which emits light by themselves, by themselves. What I'm saying here, the body which emits means what we can say, which gives, what we can say, which gives, okay, which send out, or what we can say, which produces, the body which produces light by themselves. Themselves means what I'm saying, by its own. What I'm saying, its own, not depend on others, not depend on others. Means what we can say, unique. What we can say, unique. It has a unique property. Here what I'm saying, the body which emits light by themselves. The body which produces light by itself. The body which produces light by itself. See what I'm discussing to you, the body which emits light by themselves is nothing as luminous body. What we can call luminous body. See here, how many luminous bodies are there in our universe? In our universe. What I'm talking to you, I'm talking about in universe. In our universe means all over the atmosphere, on the surface of Earth or in the space, means in the solar system. How many luminous bodies are there in our universe? We'll talk after what is the universe, what is the solar system, everything. So, how many are there means we may count on our fingers. Just there are three luminous bodies. How many are there? Three luminous bodies. Three luminous bodies are there. Then what are those? What we said, luminous body means the body which produces light by its own. Light by its own. Then the body should be produced light by itself, means it should produce by itself. Generally we can talk, a candle giving a light, is it or not? A candle giving a light, a torch light giving a light, a bulb, tube light giving a light, bulb produces a light. Of course, we can say moon also giving light, sun also giving light, stars also giving light. See here, what I'm saying, whatever we may observe in our surroundings, ferments also giving light, ferments. Of course, what you are calling furnace in general language, chimney or poi something. Okay? Coming to that, so we are not calling such a those which are producing light. Where means by what object we are getting light, the objects which are producing light, those all objects we are not calling as luminous bodies. We are calling a specialized bodies only luminous bodies. We are calling a particular, a unique substances. Means the properties is separated. Means which bodies we call? The bodies which are producing light by themselves. They are giving light by their own. Suppose if you want to get light from the furnace, what you are calling chimney or poi, we have to use firewood to burn. By giving fire to the firewood, it is giving light. Tube light giving light by burning of filament by the electrical energy. Is it or not? Torch light giving light by the uses of chemical energy from the cell. Understand? What we are talking here? Wax candle is giving light by burning of wax along with wick. Along with the wick. Wick. What is the thread is present in that? Okay. In that wax candle. So, what we are discussing such as those all are giving by someone help. Those all are giving light by someone's help. I'm saying it is depend on others, means other substances. But what you are calling here, the body should not depend on others. It gives it, but the body should give light by their own. The body should give light by their own. Understand? Then what are the luminous bodies in our universe? First of all, we can talk about, we will raise a question to talk about luminous body, which is the primary source of light to the earth. Can you answer for that? Which is the primary source of light to the earth? We are getting light, that's why we are able to see our surroundings, our sceneries. We are able to look ourselves due to the only light. Already we discussed in the reflection of light. Is it or not? Okay, no need to discuss again. That coming to that. So, which is the primary? Primary means a first source of light to the earth. That we can say, which is the primary source of light to the earth is nothing as sun. What is that? Sun. Sun is the primary source of light to the earth. Sun is the primary source of light to the earth. So why you want to talk about sun here to the luminous body? What we call about luminous body? Luminous bodies, the body which emits light by themselves. Of course, sun giving light by itself, by its own. Sun produces light by its own. How sun will produce light its own? Can you? Due to the nuclear fusion is going on the surface of the sun. Due to the nuclear fusion. Means the reaction between what atoms? The reaction between nuclear atoms. Radioactive elements. The reaction between hydrogen and helium. They are reacting continuously on the surface of the sun. Due to the collision, we are getting light, heat and sound. Are you understand? Light, heat and sound. But one thing, we are getting light and heat from the sun, but we are unable to hear the sound from the sun. Is it or not? We are unable to listen the sound from the sun. Is it? Of course. Because of sound need medium to propagate. Means sound needs depend on medium to propagate from one place to another place. Means sound is traveling by a particular medium which is helping to propagate from one place to another place. So in the space there is no medium of the particle. So that's why sound is not traveling through the vacuum. There is no particles of the medium, we can say. That is what? Vacuum. So sound is not travel through the vacuum. It is depends on the medium. That's why you are not getting sound from the sun. Understand? At the same time, light is not depend on the medium. It can travel in the straight path. Understand? That's why you are getting light and heat from the sun. Why sun delivers light continuously? Because due to the nuclear reaction or nuclear fusion between the nuclear atoms, between hydrogen and helium continuously by the nuclear reaction. We know once we may heard that when US, America dropped two atom bombs, nuclear bombs on the surface of Japan, which are economical states in Japan. One is Nagasaki and Hiroshima. Those two atom bombs or nuclear bombs are given how much destruction it was, collapsed the whole economical state in that country. Up to now also, there is no the growing of a grass bit. There is no growing of a grass bit in that particular where the US dropped, Americans have dropped that atom bombs on the particular states of country, Japan country. Understand? Such a that much effect, now also they are affecting by that poisonous gases. Such a like, there are number of molecules, number of hydrogen helium molecules are collided on the surface of the sun. Due to that, it is produces light and heat and also sound. but we are getting light and heat. Okay, sun is a luminous body. Sun is a luminous body because of sun delivers or sun produces or sun emits light by itself. Understand? Coming to that, what I'm saying is, sun is a smallest star. Sun is a mini star. We can ask the question. So stars are very small, but sun is a broad in size. Is it? It is a broad in a spherical size. Of course. Why? Because we'll clarify that. Why? Because size is different. And coming to that, second luminous body is a star. So stars, we may very happy to enjoy during the night, because if you are in open field by sleeping during night, at night we may enjoy those light by giving a spark from the star. Is it or not? Of course. So coming to that, stars also producing light by itself. Understand? How those will be produced light by their own, because the reaction between gas molecules present in a star. Stars are made up of gas and dust particles. Understand? See here what I'm saying. So stars are producing light by itself by the reaction between gases, by burning of the gases at inside the star. Understand? That's why it produces light by itself, light by own. Understand? Light by the stars is giving own. That's why I'm calling stars are the luminous bodies. So two, we discussed luminous bodies. But before I said sun is a mini star, but sun appears a larger size than to the star. Is it? Because of the distance between the sun to the earth is 150 million kilometers. Means 150 crore kilometers around, you can compare that. 150 million kilometers. 1 million is equal to 10 lakhs. By compare that, we can calculate how we like. So 150 million kilometer distance between the sun to the earth. Understand? See here, the distance compared to that, the stars are very far from the sun. And their sizes are very larger than the sun also. What I'm saying to you, the stars are very far from the sun. See, we are comparing just from the earth to sun is a very far distance. It is 150 million kilometers. It is an unpredictable distance, is it or not? Of course. But stars are very, very far from the sun. But size of the stars are larger than the sun. But why it appears as smaller? Because the duration, but a distance. Because stars are appear smaller in size due to the stars are very far. That's why it appears as a small. Sun is closer to the earth. So by that, what happened? By that, we may get the what? Maximum size into the stars. Understand? Coming to the what I'm saying to you here. So sun is a star. You can call what is sun is a star. Because star means what we discussed, of course, luminous body means the body which produces light, which emits light by itself, Understand? So by that, what we can consider here, so sun is a star, it is a small star, mini star we can say. Understand? Then third one, which is that? Third luminous body. Which is the third luminous body? Can you answer for which is the third luminous body? We may observe on the surface of our earth a small insect. What is that? Insect. Third one I'm saying to you, what a luminous body? Insect on the earth. During at night, we may get a small insect moving by producing light at their tail. In Telugu, we can call that Minuguru Purugu. Is it? So that small insect produces light at the tail. Due to the chemical reactions at the tail of the insect, it produces light to itself. Light itself. Means the small insect produces light by itself, by its own, because of chemical reactions at the tail. Understand? So these three are the luminous bodies in our universe. Then what about moon? Moon also producing light, no? During night, we are getting light from the moon. It's completely cool breeze. Is it or not? We are enjoying very happy with that full moon and some vibar or whatever that shape of the moon. Is it or not? When it is giving crescent moon, a single line, we are looking to other faces also. Is it or not? By changes of their faces, we are following such a light. However, it is naturally forming in our universe. Okay? But moon also giving light, then why are not calling luminous body? Is it or not? We may raise the question. Is it? Moon is a not luminous body because of it is not giving light by itself. It is not giving light by itself. Then how it is giving light? If moon is not producing light, then how moon producing light during at night? Because reflecting from the sun. Reflecting of a light from the sun. What I'm saying to you, when sunlight fall on the moon surface, it bounce back to the out with same angle. Means the moon is a reflector body. Moon is a reflector. It is reflecting light from the sun. Understand? So moon is not a luminous body. It is a, what you can say, non-luminous body. Can you say what is a luminous body? The body which emits light by themselves or its own itself. Those we can call luminous bodies. Then what are non-luminous bodies? What are non-luminous bodies? The bodies which are not producing or emit light by their own. Those bodies we can call non-luminous bodies. Non-luminous bodies. Do you understand what we discussed? See carefully. Okay, coming to see carefully what I'm saying to you. Then we'll talk about what we discussed about star. What is a star means? Star is a luminous body, we discussed. Then we'll talk about solar system. After we'll enter into the lesson. First we're talking about name of the lesson. Okay, see here. See what I'm saying to you. See that what I'm saying to you? See here, is it visible, those what I written? Yeah. Coming to that, we must talk about universe. What is the mean of universe? Milky Way galaxy, solar system, planets, satellites, natural satellites, artificial satellites, asteroids, comets. These all are present in our universe. These all are present in our universe. Okay, we have to learn by step by step what are those. See, Milky Way galaxy is a part of the universe. Such a like Milky Way galaxies are means a such a galaxies are number of Milky Way is the name of a galaxy. Galaxy is a group of stars. Galaxy is a group of stars. Means group of stars, planets, group of celestial bodies we can call directly. Group of celestial bodies, heavenly bodies. Celestial bodies are heavenly bodies. What does we can start about? Then what is the mean of universe? What is the mean of universe? Can you talk what is the mean of universe? See here. What is the mean of universe? See. Universe. All the existing matter, all the existing matter and all existing matter and space, consider space, consider space, considered a whole is what you can call the universe. What I'm saying, universe. What is the mean of universe? I'm saying to you, or what you can say, the celestial sphere. Celestial sphere. Universe. What is the mean of universe? See, all the existing matter and space consider, the whole is called the universe. Or otherwise we are calling, the celestial sphere is called universe. The celestial sphere is called universe. Means what? All the existing matter in the universe, all over the matter. The matter is made up of the atoms. Matter consists of mass. See, in the all the, what happened? All the existing matter in a space and space consider. Means there is a vacuum consider. It consists of vacuum and what are present? All the matters are present in the space. This whole what you are calling universe. We are also in the universe. That's also a part in a universe. Is it or not? You may feel we are at downside. We are not in down, we are floating. Not in float, we can say. We are in space. Our earth is staying in space. We are on the surface of the earth. Our earth is staying in the space, inside the space, in the universe. How like it is, we may feel existence. See, after we'll discuss clear about how it is. Okay? See, what I'm saying, all the existing matter and space, the matter means the substances and the space consider where whole those we are calling the universe. Otherwise, celestial sphere. Celestial sphere. What is the mean of celestial? What is the mean of celestial? Can you? The objects which are in heaven. The objects which are in heaven. What I'm saying to you, see here. The objects of the sky are heaven. What I'm saying to you? The objects which are present in the sky are what you are calling heaven. Heaven means in Telugu what you can, it is a happiest place, swargam. Generally we are saying heaven means where somewhere we are saying, but no more anything in our, but after whatever it is. Coming to that, what I am saying, objects of the sky are heaven. The objects, the matter which is present in the sky are in heaven. Those what you are calling celestial bodies are celestial sphere. Celestial sphere means what I am saying, sky means what I am saying, it is a space. Consider, or it is a heaven, what you are calling. The bodies which are present in universe, what we written here, existing matter, the matter which is present in universe, those all we can call what? That is a, what heaven. Means our earth is one of the heaven. Our earth is in heaven, of course. Because it is in the universe. Our earth is a, earth is in heaven because it is in the universe. Means the universe is a celestial sphere. Celestial sphere, what you are saying, it is a heaven apart. The part which is consists matter and space. Are you understand? Our earth is placed in heaven. Okay? See, coming to that, what I am saying, the bodies which are in heaven or in the sky, those we are calling celestial bodies, which are planets, natural satellites, comets, asteroids, whatever, sun, all our celestial bodies are heavenly bodies. Celestial bodies are heavenly bodies. Understand? Celestial bodies are heavenly bodies. Okay? See here, what I am saying, universe means what? The all existing matter and space considered. The whole is called the universe of the celestial sphere. Understand? See carefully. Then galaxy means what we discussed? The part of combination of otherwise group of celestial spheres. Yes, group of celestial bodies. A group of stars under celestial bodies. This is group of celestial bodies you can call galaxy. Of course, generally you can call constellation is a group of stars. Constellation is a group of stars. In that galaxy also it consists of group of stars and planets and natural whatever present in our those. So such a like galaxies are present in millions of galaxies present in our universe. But we are saying in the galaxy, the name of galaxy what is Milky Way galaxy. We are staying in the Milky Way galaxy. Such a like galaxies are millions of galaxies are there in the universe. Understand? By collection of what our sun, our planets, what are there, our solar system is present in there, Milky Way galaxy. Our galaxy is what you are calling Milky Way galaxy. What is the nearest galaxy to the Milky Way is Andromeda galaxy. What is that? Andromeda galaxy is the nearest galaxy to the Milky Way galaxy. Means it is not a something what? It is a also group of something. Stars or any planets, natural, celestial bodies, heavenly bodies. That also means, suppose how I am saying galaxy means, suppose this is our place is located, our name of the place is a Pormamilla. Is it or not? So Pormamilla is a group of what are the private institutions, government institutions and offices, whatever, houses and places and whatever the combination, rivers, oceans, means whatever, forests, and ponds, lakes, if it's there, what I'm saying. Such a like, we are, how we divided the earth as a part by the name, like our universe also divided by some of the groups as a name. Some of the groups as a names in our universe. Such a like, we divided the name as a galaxy by the particular name. There are millions galaxies are there with the different names. What I'm saying, we are saying the name of the galaxy is the Milky Way galaxy. In Telugu, we can call that Palapunta. What you can call? Palapunta, Milky Way galaxy. The nearest galaxy to the Milky Way is the Andromeda galaxy. What is that? Andromeda galaxy. Let's talk about that solar system. What is the mean of solar system? Understand? What is that? We are talking about solar system. What is the mean of solar system? The sun and the celestial bodies. The sun and celestial body. What I am saying? Sun and the celestial body. The sun and the celestial bodies, which revolve around it from the, which revolve around from the, around it from the it from the solar system. Solar system is what I am saying. See here. The sun and the celestial body which revolve around it. Around it means what? Around it means the celestial bodies are revolve around the sun in the solar system. Solar system. The sun and the celestial bodies. The sun and the celestial bodies. The celestial bodies are revolve around the sun. Around the sun. This is what we are calling solar system. This is our solar system is the placed in the galaxy Milky Way galaxy. The name of the galaxy is the Milky Way galaxy. The sun is the center of the solar system and also head of the solar system. What I'm saying, sun is the sun is the center of the solar system and also head of the solar system. Head of the solar system. What I'm saying? The sun is the center of the solar system and the head of the solar system, which is the sun. And also what happened? All what is there means planets and what are revolving around it here, planets and the other moons. Planets and other moons, other moons, and also what we can write, asteroids and comets, meteoroids. And coming to talk about some debris forming. Around the sun. What I'm saying? Planets and other moons, asteroids, comets, meteoroids. Okay? And which are, what are present in our universe, means in our solar system. All are revolve around the sun. Understand? So, this solar system is placed in where we call, the name of the galaxy, what? Milky Way galaxy. Okay? Coming to that. How is our solar system? How is our solar system? Let me talk about that. See here. See, this is the What I am showing to you, sun. This is I'm showing sun. What is that? Sun. And see how the whole celestial bodies are revolve around the sun. All celestial bodies are revolve around the sun. They are revolving around the sun in a specified path. Those specified path, not a path. In the specified path, those we are calling what? Orbit. What we are calling? Orbit. Okay. See here. What are those? See one, sir. There are generally nowadays we are learning the number of planets are 8 are revolve around the sun. But generally there are 9 planets are revolve around the sun. There are 9 planets revolve around the sun. Then what are those? See here, the first planet from the sun. The first planet from the sun is what we can call the Mercury. What we can call Mercury. Is it visible that? Mercury. And second one, second planet from the sun is a Venus. I'm saying to you, Venus. Third planet from the sun is Earth. Third planet from the sun is Earth. Fourth planet from the sun is Mars. Fifth planet from the sun is Jupiter. Jupiter. Seventh planet from the sun is a, what I'm saying, Saturn. Saturn. Next, what we are going to talk about, Uranus. And next, Neptune. And last, Pluto. But we are talking, we are learning about just 8 planets. About only 8 planets. Why? Because that will discuss why we are not talking about 9th planet. Because by going a lesson about each and every planet, we may get why we are not talking, learning about Pluto. Okay. See here, what I'm saying, Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune, Pluto. So how many planets are set here? 9, but if any comprehension purpose, if you want to write, if they ask the question how many planets are revolve around the sun, you have to write only 8. Okay? If they ask a particular date before, there was a 9. But there is a 9th planet. It is not moved anywhere. Okay, it is there. It is revolve around the sun. See what I am saying? The first planet from the sun is a Mercury. Second planet from the sun is a Venus. Third planet from the sun is Earth. And fourth one is a Mars. Okay? See here. First one is a Mercury. Second, Venus. Third, Earth. Fourth, Mars. 5th Jupiter, 6th Saturn, 7th Uranus, 8th Neptune, 9th Pluto. See here, what I am saying to you, you have to recognize one between the see, each planet are having some of the natural satellites. See, whole planets are revolve around the sun. Whole planets revolve around the sun. But some of the celestial bodies revolve around the planets. Some of the celestial bodies are revolve around the planets. So those we are calling moons or satellites. Natural satellites are moons. Moon. The bodies which are revolve around the planet. The celestial bodies which are revolve around the planet, those we are calling means natural satellites are what you can call moons. Natural satellites are moons. So this is general information to that what are present in solar system. But we have to learn step by step to class before this. Okay, what you want to learn? Let's we talk about that. Coming to that. See here what I'm saying to you. We may observe what you may observe by sunrise and sunset. See here what we have to rise. Why? Sun rise takes always at east. Why sunset takes always at west? And also we may observe what we can. Generally, those whole planets are in the where in the same besides of the each planet and to the sun. But why we are looking to the top, this height to look the sun and the moon, to look the sun and the moon. And also, how the what are the properties of the each and every planet, and also about stars, what type of stars are there. And the natural satellites, what about that? And the revolution, rotations, we have to learn about that. And we have to talk about moon, special character of moon, and what is the revolve and rotation, and what is Nisa, why we are getting seasons and days, how time changes. Okay, seasons are changing, and why moons are changing their phases, why moons are changing their phases. Understand? Such like we have to discuss. See, after that we will discuss by each and every planet in the solar system and celestial bodies in the solar system. See, what I am saying, if you stand at in front of the sun, if you stand at in front of the sun means at by rising time. When you are standing at by rising time, by sun rising time, at in front of the sun in open field, what we may observe when you are standing at a sun rising time, at in open or at in front of the sun rising time or in the open field, we may observe our shadow is how our shadow, how the direction of our shadow, and what is the length of our shadow, what is the length of our shadow. And also one more, during the evening means during the sunset, if you stand at in front of the sun in open field, we may observe our shadow, how what is the direction of shadow and what is the length of the shadow. And when you are standing at noon time in the open field under the sun, what is our shadow position, what is the shadow direction, and what is the length of the shadow. Understand? Such like we have to discuss. We may observe when you are standing at sunrise during the morning session, we may observe our length of the shadow forms towards the west. Our shadow direction is towards a formation of the shadow direction there towards the west direction. During the sunset, when you are standing in the open field at in front of the sun, we may observe our direction, shadow direction is towards the east. Why we are getting such a like shadow to opposite? And also we may observe the length of the shadow is more during the sunrise and during the sunset then to the sun noon time. The length of the shadow is more during sunset, sunrise, then to the noon time. Why? Because what is the main reason? And also we have to learn what is the direction of rotation to the earth and what is the direction of rotation to the sun. Is it the sun revolves? Is sun revolves? Or it will rotate. If it rotate, how it will rotate? Such a like we will discuss in the next class. Okay, I have to recall what we finish and be ready for preparation for examination. Keep learning. Okay, see you in the next class. Have a good day to you.